guys, we're going to Epcot today, and just to tell you now, so it's my birthday in a few days, so we went to Disney, and now we're going to Epcot today. I'm wearing my birthday shirt and my Stitch thing that I bought.
We're here. Are you excited?
Yeah. So we're heading to France. It's just in the park. I see China! Wait, is the building a ride?
Yeah, we can't go in there though.
Cute.
The dragon made out of flowers.
I want to go inside.
You can't go in there.
What's in here?
That's kind of like the Frozen one, I think.
Yeah, but
because I know that's what this is.
Is there a ride in Italy?
No.
What?
Only a restaurant. Oh, look at the doggies made out of plants. Oh, look at the train. We're in Germany now. I think it's right up here. I think it's the next one.
I can see our hotel.
You can?
I saw us.
You did?
Yeah.
Right. I bet there's a line.
I bet there's a huge line.
We got the fast line. Yeah.
No, he's awesome.
You want to stand with him? No, stand in front of his hand so he grabs you. There you go.
Oh, no, 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 Discoveries, the figment of imagination.
Yeah, and I know all about the senses. Their sight, sound, smell, touch, goochie goochie go, and taste. Taste my chicken. Can I go? Please, please, please.
No, I don't want you out of my sight.
Out of sight? Okay. Come on, everybody. Here we go.
Figment, you are not to interfere with the tour. By using the eye chart to test your vision. Now, all together, if you would please read line three.
You can see things differently. Sure, you can see with your eyes, but imagine what you could see if you used your imagination. Follow the bouncing figment. One spark of light. You can light your fancy. Your mind sees more than what your eyes see. Your sense of sight can make your fancy fly. It's a good time to use your imagination, so let the good times roll! Woohoo! You win one cent!
Thank you.
sorry. Oh, that's our card.
Hey, look. To the greatest diversity of plants on the planet. Many of these, like papaya, bananas, cacao, coffee, and rice, are well known around the world. These are just a few of the edible plants that have been an important source of nutrition for people living in the tropics. Many are rich in vitamins and minerals, while others are well adapted to growing in best and ideal conditions. Some, like the water lily,
thrive
in wet, swampy areas and waterways. All parts of this plant, even the flower petal, are edible. The starchy root of the plant has long been used to make flour for baking. One day, many of these lesser-known tropical plants may be as important as the bananas growing on both sides of the boat. More than 28 million tons of bananas are eaten annually, making it the most popular fruit in the world. The common grains growing here, maize, sorghum, and millet, plus rice, account for nearly two-thirds of our global consumption. Learning how to increase yields of these staples is an important goal of research around the world. These plants are definitely on their way up. Innovative growing techniques like these increase yields while more efficiently using resources like water, fertilizer, and pesticides. Another innovation at work here is our integrated pest management program. By populating our greenhouses with beneficial insects that prey on harmful pests, like aphids and flies, we are significantly reducing our reliance on conventional pesticides. We're growing these crops using our nutrient film system. This technique precisely controls and recycles water and nutrients. With it, we can produce over 27,000 heads of lettuce a year in this one small area. Some of our best ideas have been inspired by nature, like these fruit and vegetable trees. By growing these ground plants vertically, we can increase yields and better control diseases. These crops taste as good as they look. In fact, we serve more than 15 tons of produce from our greenhouses and restaurants here at the land every year. Another great way to produce more while using